Real talk.
Real talk.
Real talk. Real talk with Nasir.
Good morning, basketball world. On today's show, we have a special guest, Jim and Titus, also known as the Brown Mamba. So, Jim, how are you doing today?
I'm doing pretty good. First of all, let me thank you for having me on this show.
Oh, no problem. So, I see you just came off the best career of your season. You just won the finals championship, finals MVP, and then 6 games of the 2016 season, you're averaging 30 points, 15 rebounds, and 12 assists.
Yeah, it's been a long journey, let me tell you that. I never thought I would get this far, but hard work and dedication, that's all I can say.
Hard work and dedication. Those words, I hear them like every day on TV. It's very cliche for my young viewers. Tell us the deeper meaning of hard work and dedication.
Well, let me say, I started at a young age. I played pretty much every sport, basketball, football, even a little bit of baseball. But once I got to high school, ninth grade, I found my true passion for basketball. And I started practicing every day, as many as 6 to 8 hours a day. And I knew this is what I wanted to do. So I tried out for the basketball team every year, but unfortunately I never made it. It was tough days, but I knew one day my time would come.
So not ever making your basketball, high school basketball team, which sometimes people hear everyone does. What made you keep having the passion to play basketball and pursue your career into your college days?
There was definitely some tough days where I wanted to give up, but I had a love for the game that I just had to keep playing. So I knew I just had to keep going. And once I got to UGA, I kept playing pickup ball at Ramsey. And I knew I was good compared to the players at the gym. So I tried out my sophomore year, and fortunately I made the team, and I went from there.
So sophomore year to senior year, and you were an average player. You kind of got better, became the star your senior year. So what made you, in your senior year, what was your thought process of how I actually have the potential to go overseas and play, and then one day eventually play in the NBA?
Well, I knew basketball was what I wanted to do with my life. So, unfortunately, I mean, I wasn't good enough at that time to be drafted into the NBA. So I went overseas, played there for a couple of seasons, worked on my game. So, and then I got fortunately drafted by the Atlanta Hawks, 42nd overall in the second round. And that's how my NBA career began. And I was only on the bench for the first couple of seasons, but I didn't mind that. It was just a great experience learning from all the veteran players and the coaching. It was very helpful, and I finally got my starting job in my fourth season, and that's how my success started.
Last story, thank you for that story. It's very inspirational for all my viewers out there. Young and old, just know, never give up and fight through the obstacles. Now, we're cut to commercial here. While we're gone, we asked the audience a few questions, and they said it's very hard to believe that you came from never making your basketball team in high school to all the way becoming a star in the NBA.
Well, it was not by myself at all. I had my trainer and mentor, Herman Tucker. This man brought me to where I am today. Before him, I couldn't even make a shot.
And we conveniently have video Jim and airborne a lot of shots. Oh, so you see from the video, Jimbo was very bad. So Herman, why did you decide to train Jimbo?
Well, obviously because he sucked, but it wasn't just because of that. It's just, I saw potential in him. He was a great basketball player in his heart. Not on the court, but in his heart. But I knew he could be something great, and look where he is now.
Okay. Here's some video of Herman training Jimbo, also known as the Brown Mamba. Between you and your trainer?
Me and Herman are very close. At first, he was only my basketball trainer, but now he has become a mentor in my life. He's taught me many life lessons. He's taught me how to be a professional, and he's just very important to me right now.
So what is your favorite aspect or most memorable aspect that Herman taught you?
One of my most favorite quotes that Herman taught me was, "When the going gets tough, the tough get going." And that's been with me through my whole life, from high school to the NBA.
Okay. Thank you for your story. It was very inspirational for all my young and old viewers out there. Now, to everyone, good night. And remember, work hard today to achieve your dreams tomorrow.
The hustle continues. Getting money is. Yep. Getting money is.
Put your mind in.